I've seen it all and I know better. I've felt the bitterness and pain. My soul keeps changing like the weather. The only constant is the rain. I know your black and white intentions, and there's no room for shades of gray. I never asked you to conform to me. I never begged for you to stay. Waited here tonight for you to come, but your love just disappeared. Waiting in the dark for miracles. Miracles don't happen here. Miracles don't happen here. Miracles don't happen here. I still have dreams that we're together, and I can still taste your skin. Reminders all around, surrounded by your light. I don't wanna die again. I don't deserve to be discovered. I don't deserve to know you care. I only want my promised other, not someone who isn't there. Waited here tonight for you to come, but your love just disappeared. Waiting in the dark for miracles, but miracles don't happen here. Miracles don't happen here. Miracles don't happen here.
Stone Sour, who of course are headlining, co-headlining Laserfest on Sunday, May 15th. The Indianola Balloon Grounds.
And yes, we will play more than 10 songs.
Awesome. We can't wait.
I read that question. I was like, really? What?
We do have more questions. And I'm going to hand it off to my co-host, Caress Carter, for the next couple.
Oh, yeah, yeah. See, she was in on the meeting. She knows what the plot is.
Sometimes you have to let him just
kind of
work it through. You know how Andy is.
They grow up so fast.
We had a lot of great questions. Amanda wanted to know, do you ever get tired of being famous? I mean, do people hound you when you're at McDonald's? I mean, does it ever get tiresome?
How do you... yes. It's weird, but it's, you know, I mean, half the time you forget you're famous, you know. I mean, it doesn't hurt that, you know, we kind of, you know, we stayed in our hometown. We still have the same friends that we've had since we were 14, you know. It's, you're only as famous as, it's, there's the difference between being famous and then acting famous. A lot of people will just expect you to treat them differently because they are quote-unquote, you know, big, stupid rock stars. Whereas we're like you know, can I just get my burger? I get it. It's all good. Thank you. It's, you know, I mean, it's, it is what it is, you know? I mean, there's a time and a place for it, and it's not that we don't appreciate the fans and appreciate what they've helped us do, but at the same time, we don't roll around and expect to be treated any differently than we have for the last 20 years. So, in a way, sometimes it's weird, but for the most part, it's just like, oh, yeah, we are famous. All right, that's weird. But it's, I mean, we never remember.
Yeah. I feel the same. I feel the same. Well put. I don't have anything else really to add. I mean, I don't know. I don't consider myself famous. I just do my thing, I guess. So.
Oh, that's true. I mean, you know, I mean, we've been, you know, we've known each other since we were 15 years old. And, you know, a lot of the friends that we have, you know, were in the basement with us when we were putting this stuff together. They were with us when we went and played, you know, weird, crazy gigs. They've seen us come to where we are now, and it's still us, you know. I guess it depends on how you act, you know. I mean, there's a huge difference between us and people like, well, I probably shouldn't say any names.
Oh, come on, we want names.
I'm not that guy. You don't call me up. But, well, okay, perfect example. I've a lot of friends who, you know, work in the industry and whatnot, and there's a person that we know who is actually out on the road with a certain lead singer, and you know exactly what I'm talking about, Jason. And apparently they spent a good 4 hours trying to get into a few clubs for free because he was blah 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 from blah blah blah, and they were like, we don't care, it's $5 to get in. So they, and it was like that at pretty much every club, and it was awesome because this guy is a douchebag and deserved to get shut down like that. Whereas I would have been like, $5, oh, there you go, and in, and then just see, you're in the club, $5, you're in the club already. Now you're just, he's outside, he's just pissed. Get over yourself, man. Really, I mean, sorry, was that too much?
You guys seem really well grounded, and it's probably your Iowa roots is what I'm going to go ahead and make the assumption.
That and the subliminal motivation tapes.
So give some more advice to Paul, who's a struggling musician.
Okay.
And he wants to know what he can do to get noticed.
Well, running naked down Grand will definitely I'll get you noticed. I don't think it's the right kind of notice. It's a lot of work, man, you know? I mean, with both bands, with Slipknot and Stone Sour, it's been a lot of work. But it's, the you know, there's a point where it pays off. The work definitely pays off. You go out there and you grind it out, and you grind it out. I mean, it's hard work, it's talent, it's being in the right place at the right time, and there's a lot of luck to it as well, you know? You know, there's still a lot of great bands that I know who haven't even gotten as far as we have, and they definitely deserve it because they're very good bands, but it's just, it's a lot of work, and you can't let yourself get discouraged because people like Kim Kardashian get a record, right? Have you guys heard that piece of crap? Wow. No, do yourself a favor and listen to it once so you know what not to listen to. It's bad. It's almost as bad as Paris Hilton's single that she put out. Yeah, that rap album. Really? Good idea. But it's, you can't let stuff like that discourage you. You just have to keep doing what you do, and you have to believe in yourself, and you have to kind of come to the conclusion that no amount of hard work is too much. You have to do the work, you know? I mean, we went out and we just, you know, we beat it into the ground. And now, you know, I mean, luckily we're able to do, you know, it's our third album. It's doing really well. And we're coming home to headline, you know, Laserfest. I mean, that it took a long time to get to that point, you know, and you can't do that without hard work. So, I mean, that's really what it comes down to. Am I right?
Yes. I forgot what the question
was. Oh, you. You nailed me, you little shit. It's how do you get noticed? It's struggling musician, get noticed.
It's a lot of work. Just keep playing.
Josh doesn't talk a lot. So I'm going to let him do the rest of the talking.
But when I do, everybody listens.
He's like, yeah, Putin. Way young. That's... I might as well just start telling Nixon jokes at this point. Well, now that I'm uncomfortable, what do you...
I'm glad we brought Josh into the fold here, because my next question was from a Jason Martin. He wanted to know if Josh speaks.
Where's he at?
Jerk face.
Hiding.
He's the one that set the alarm off earlier, by the way. If you heard the alarm going off, that's because I was trying to go out and have a cigarette. And Jason's like, what's this door do? And I'm like, everyone knows it's us. Everyone is going to know it's us. So thank you, Jason Martin, for that